Sling bass and that. Oh, just only to hold the rod because you'll pull it. The motor can't even work against it.
That's a big bass today.
Holy sh. Yeah, just hold the rod, just hold the rod.
Holy sh. Bags, that's some colour.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, yes, boy!
Holy sh. Oh, look at the size of that thing.
Now, of course, when you're dropping way down into the depths, when you're fishing for bluenose, harp hooker, bass, or even gemfish, you don't want to drop your bait 300 or 400 metres only to have your bait come off or get nibbled off by a small fish. So I use the addition of a rubber band on the hook. Now, I've just got a whole mackerel here, and whenever you're using a circle hook, you don't want to crowd the hook. So you only really want to put it just through the end of the bait, like so. But of course, with not a lot of hook purchase there, that can get pulled off easily. That's where the rubber band comes in. I just use a bait needle onto the rubber band, and I'm going to poke that rubber band through the eye socket. Now that it's through there, I just wrap that around the hook a couple of times, back over the hook, and now that bait can't be ripped off the hook, yet there's still plenty of hook showing to give you a nice clean hookup. The rubber band trick when dropping deep for harp hooker, bass, bluenose, or even gemfish.
I like to look at the bottom 50 metres when I'm out here looking for bluenose and harp hooker, because sometimes they can be well up off the bottom. And this is where the bottom lock sort of paid off for me. I've got all of this sort of bait and feed down here on the edge, but at this particular point here, you can see it's really dark and concentrated. So I've got a good mark, so I can just touch that now. New point. Anything that I'm checking out, I choose to mark it as a flag until I can go back and confirm it. And you can see that there, that dark patch is represented on my plotter. But that was good enough for me. The thing to do now is work out our drift direction. I can move up, we can run some baits through that concentration of marks. And well, it looks like a couple of predators down there as well. We'll see if that's target species.
John,
you're on. You're doing a good job there, mate. You guys are in for some good eating, because these things, I tell you, the bass. Now here's a graphic example of exactly why we'd put that rubber band on. On this hook, I just had a wee bit of squid, got nibbled away to death. The tougher bait, down here, if we open up the gob of this beautiful bass that we caught, you see the rubber band has held that bait in place, circle hook in the corner of the mouth. And you'll also notice while you're looking at this rig, we've got a wee light on it. Now, if you'd like to see exactly how we tie all this rig up, of course, you can see that right here at ultimatefishing.tv. Full instructional videos on how to make this whole rig. And in fact, we've got a whole lot of tips on fishing the deep for these fish.